So today I've been on the trail for 1 month, being on my own almost all of the time. I've learned a lot about myself, what triggers me if I'm tripping or falling, if I lose the trail, if I make a mistake in any way, I get angry. If the weather is shitty or if it's a lot of mosquitoes, I also tend to get very, very annoyed. While I've been walking through the marshes, there has been this one bird that has this shriek of just one note. But to enjoy the moment and to be here now, I'm starting to really get the hang of it. Of course, it's much harder when I'm wet, I'm cold, and I'm miserable. I'm really grateful for the tough days as well, because they have taught me to be grateful for the nice and the easier days. In the beginning, I was not sure if I could pull this off. Now, however, I'm very confident and I'm in no doubt that I'm gonna make it. There's a lot of trail gossip, which I listen to, but I try not to judge it until I can confirm it myself. What someone finds extremely difficult, someone else think is simple. It also depends on weather and conditions. Lionel, who warned me of this river crossings that he had to do, when I got there, like maybe 2 weeks later than him, it had been dry and warm for over a week. So where he had water up to his waist, I could jump from stone to stone, keeping my shoes nice and dry. So yeah, it was a completely different experience from what he had. This is just as much a mental journey as it is a physical one, but I've definitely gotten stronger. I can walk further every day without spending all of my energy. It's clear that it's more inhabited here in this the further south that I go, or at least that the trail is more popular. Because the trail is really well marked. It's bridges over the worst rivers, and the trekking association has also put planks in a lot of the marshes so that you can just walk over. And I've had days with dry feet. To walk alone has been the best thing. I had to take the decisions even though I've been very insecure, and the only thing I could do was just to try and then move on and learn from my decisions. I haven't seen much wildlife. Supposedly the area that I've been walking through is inhabited by bears, wolverines and moose, but the only thing I've seen is a frog, a dead hare, a lot of birds and reindeer. Quite close to Kautokeino, I thought it was a dog running towards me on the path, but it was a weird sound for a dog to make, I thought. And when it got closer, I saw it was a baby reindeer. He seemed to be lost, looking for his mother or something. He ran back and forth and followed me for a little while before running into the forest. I can't believe it's been 1 month. So, the adventure continues. I still have another 3 months to walk. I'm following this river today. I'm sorry if it's a bit noisy, but it's a bit windy. Oh, nice. With all this wind, I can walk in my shorts and t-shirt in peace. Just had a bath and now I'm gonna make myself some lunch and just relax here by this little beach that I've found for a couple of hours, I guess, before walking. I'm not gonna walk too far today, but a little bit further. That is the best thing ever. When you've been out for 5-6 hours in the rain. I was thinking of walking a little further, but I'm so tired. So I think I'm gonna be very kind to myself and just enjoy this stay. I think I'm gonna have a nap right now. Actually, it's only like 3:30. I just arrived at Vokterboligen, the cabin that I'm gonna get my resupply. I'm also gonna spend the night. But the guy who's gonna open the cabin for me is not gonna arrive until maybe 3 o'clock. It's now 12:30. So I've taken shelter in the shed. And I'm making myself hot cocoa. And then, yeah, hopefully he will arrive pretty soon.